Respect your fathers and teachers, brothers and sisters. Good morning to you all. First of all, I wish you all a happy Teachers' Day. I am very honored. It is my pleasure to stand in front of you all. You know why? Because you all are teachers. I am a student. I am very honored and I am with immense pleasure to stand in front of you all to say something. That's all. I am very happy to be here as a guest of honor, especially in front of your principal who has received the award. And moreover, first of all, Father said, you are missing the day. Yes? Father said you missed the day. Other students used to come and welcome you and give you gifts. Really, are you missing the children or the children are missing you? On this day, you are missing the children or children are missing you? I think the children are missing you. That I think children are missing you because they love you so much and you inspire them. On this day, they miss you so much on their behalf. I wish you once again a happy Teacher's Day. And moreover, I say, teacher or teaching is not a profession, it is a passion. When you consider such a profession, you mean give something and we take something. But when you take it as a passion, we live it and we die in that. That's the teaching. We take it as a passion, we live, we don't merely teach them to learn, but we give an example. By our example, they learn. Better than we teach, they learn by themselves by looking at us. We are going through a very peculiar situation, which is abnormal in our days, which is COVID-19 pandemic. Have you ever thought, what will be the situation after this? When the classes are reopened, what will be the situation? Do they really need the teachers? Do they really need the teachers? Say some. Now they don't need the teachers. They have the information through the online classes or the internet. We go to the YouTube. Whatever you want, there is a lot of information. In this situation, do we need teachers after this? If we say yes, why? Why do the children need the teacher? That's the question. Teachers are not mere search engines. Search engines like Google. Whatever you want, you put it in the Google, you get the answer. But teachers are not search engines to get the answers. Teachers not only impart the knowledge, but also values. That's what makes a difference. You are much more different than the search engines. You not only give the knowledge, but also the values. Today the media gives the knowledge, but the teachers impart wisdom. What the children need is the wisdom, not mere the knowledge. When you go through the days, as the days pass by, what they learn? Do they come with creativity? Do they express themselves in a creative way? Everybody learns the same ABCD. But how do they express that creativity, ABCD? Some understand through the pictures, some understand through the particular things, like when they see apple, then they associate it with it, yay. But some see was just hearing. Some understand through writing. That's the creativity. You just teach with the one medium and they come up with the different mediums of understanding. That's what makes you peculiar and specific. Moreover, we not only teach them to acquire knowledge, but also we teach how to live in the society. We teach them how to live in the society. We don't tell them this is right and this wrong. Maybe we say the initial status. After some time, what we teach is We make them to choose. We teach them how to choose, what to choose. We teach them what is right, what is wrong by choosing them. Or by our example, we make them to choose those things. And do we think game is wrong? No. Nobody thinks that. We not only help them to grow intellectually, but also we help them to grow physically. We give them more opportunity to go out and play. And moreover, we give more health consciousness. We tell them how to be in a house, how to be clean, and what are things has to be done to live a healthy life. So as a teacher, what we are doing is not one part. We live a life. We live a life. It is not we who live the life. The students live our life. That's important. The students are living our life. That's what makes them wise. The knowledge can be acquired from everywhere, but the wisdom can be received or captured from the teachers. That's what makes the teachers much, much more peculiar. That is why I say it is the children who misses you. It is not you are not alone missing the children, but the children are missing you. They want to have that relationship. They want to learn something. They want to earn something. Even after the pandemic is getting over, they need teachers. Just beginning of the pandemic, when the lockdowns was beginning, the children used to come and say, "Father, we are very happy. Why? Hereafter we need not go to school for a month." Very happy. Everybody will come and say, "Father, we have closed down all the books. We need not go to school." But the same children, today they are telling, "What? Father, we are missing our school. Father, we are waiting when the school will be reopened. Father, we are waiting to carry our books. Father, we are waiting to meet our teachers. Father, we are waiting to get greetings from our teachers, scolding from our teachers. Father, we are waiting to meet our friends." That's what you are. No professions will say, nobody will say, "I will go and meet again the doctor." Nobody will be happy to meet the doctor. Nobody will meet a police officer. Nobody will be happy to meet another advocate or anybody high position people. But the students are willing to come and meet the teachers again and again and again and again, because you are their part of life. You live in their life. That's what you make the difference. That's why you all are peculiar. So I conclude with this.